Back with my SPL this time, Black Oblivion from the Classiest versus TDK from the Raiders. This team Black Oblivion is using is known as was used in Snake and I think also in Smoktus. It's double Scarf Zone plus Scarf Nihiligo, and this also has T-Spikes probably to support a Command Megalady with Stored Power, because then you can poison Dark types like Tita and Greninja because you cannot hit them with Stored Power obviously. Then the Clefus rocks CM if he didn't change it. The Pharaoh is Spikes, Leech Seed, Power, Knockoff, and the Gliscor was SD. This team was made before Ultra Sun and Moon came out, so technically he could have changed the Gliscor to now have Defog instead of SD, but I'm pretty sure he kept it as SD because with a team like this, you force the opponent to Defog for you most of the time. You have Toxic Spikes, Spikes, and Rocks. On DDK's side, either the Meginoo or the Bulu, one of the two, is probably AV. Then either Greninja or Lando, one of the two, is probably Choice. Scarf, Zapdos, is, I'm expecting a standard Zapdos set with Roost, Discharge, Heatwave, and Defog. Zygarde, we have to see if it's DD Z-Move or if it's DD Berry or if it's Choice Bandit. See, Greninja go for Spikes turn 1. It's a Protein Greninja and Black Oblivion throws up the rocks. He didn't fear the Greninja having Gunk Shot. If he fears it now, after the Greninja shows Protein, he can go into Ferrothorn. If not, he can just Moonblast. This is not confirmed Scarf yet, we just know it's Protein. It could still be Expert Belt, Z-Move, Life Orb, all our options. So he goes Meginoo, so he doesn't have Gunk Shot most likely. I'm expecting this to have like maybe Ice Beam, Low Kick, and yeah, another coverage move. I'm not exactly sure which coverage move. But yeah, this is confirmed AV Meginoo from that damage. TDK could Volt Switch here. Bio could go into Ferrothorn or Gliscor. Another potential play for TDK is doubling into Greninja if it has like Ice Beam and Low Kick, because that would cover the Gliscor and the Pharaoh. That's only if he's fearing Volting into the Gliscor. Another potential double would be into Tapu Bulu. Expect that also covers the Pharaoh and the Gliscor. I'm expecting the Bulu to be either a Bandit or SD variant, now that we know that Meginoo is Assault Vest. Assault Vest Meginoo helps with the Tapu Lille matchup, with the Greninja matchup, and it also helps a bit with Tapu Koko, and he also has a Landris to check Koko. So he doesn't need AV on the Bulu, so he can afford to run offensive Bulu. So he doubles the Bulu in on the Pharaoh. Like I said, he was pretty that was a fine double, either the Bulu or the Greninja that covers the Pharaoh and the Gliscor. So now if this is Bandit, he can superpower, and if he's SD, he can just SD up. And Bio doesn't have much for this. If it's Bandit, then the Megalady walls it, yes, but if it's SD, then there's a huge problem for Bio and it kinda just gets a kill. Because Ferrothorn doesn't carry Gyro Ball anymore these days, and I'm pretty sure on this team, like I said, it was not Gyro Ball, it was Power Bleach Sheet, Knockoff, and Spikes. So and like the only one that can revenge the Bulu would be the Zone or the Nihiligo, but they don't want to switch in on superpower, or yeah, like they don't want to switch in at all. So Bio just has to sack something here, I'm not sure what it is. So that's the SD, he just gets up a spike. I would potentially sack the Gliscor, because yeah, Gliscor can help versus Zapdos if Zapdos is lacking HP ice, but you have enough other stuff to deal with Zapdos, and every time this comes in, like on Gliscor, this gets another SD, like, and so like I think Gliscor is maybe the least useful, so I would probably sack the Gliscor here. He could also, like, if he goes hard into Nihiligo or Magnezone, then they would just die to a potential superpower, so I probably wouldn't go hard into them. I'm just trying to figure out what his play is here. But yeah, TDK showed SD, and the other moves are gonna be superpower, then could be either Hornleech and Woodhammer, he could have both, or he could have only one out of the two grass moves, and then the last move could be like a coverage move, or it could be substitute. We'll have to see that. But Bio kind of has to pick his fodder here, so he goes hard Magnezone. Do we see superpower come out? We see substitute, so it's sub SD. That makes me think that he has Hornleech to get health back, because sub makes you lose health, and superpower is coverage. So he goes to superpower, picks up the Magnezone. Magnezone went for flash, can to break the sub. Now he can go Nihiligo to scare this out. TDK could go Meginoo or I guess Zygarde. Black Oblivion could either go for Toxic Spike or he could pull a double. Obviously TDK doesn't want to stay in here because this is a huge threat. It pretty much gets a kill again when it comes in on Pharaoh or Gliscor. Potentially even when it comes in on Clefable, it kind of just gets a kill. But yeah, since this showed sub, I'm pretty sure the last move is going to be Hornleech. So superpower, Hornleech, SD, and sub. Because you don't want Woodhammer if you have sub, because you would lose health. And I also think that it's the superpower and not the Grassium, because the Grassium you only run it if you have Woodhammer, and this, so like if you have Hornet you don't run that. So I think he's gonna defog here. He went into Zapdos on an Heligo, which seems like a weird play, but he probably predicted a Toxic Spike. Bio double into Lari, not sure what he predicted, but yeah, you can comment up now. Here's the Landorus. Now we will see if the Landorus faster. It is faster, so that means Choice Scarf Landorus. Now this is Calm Mind, Stored Power Lari with Sub Recover. He'd already showed Sub and CM, and like I said, I knew the team beforehand, that was pretty obvious to me. Now, he could go Zygarde, or he could go Greninja, but I assume he's gonna go Zygarde, because this is only a plus one. So Stored Power wouldn't do that much damage to Zygarde, and Zygarde can easily scare this out. But yeah, he went for a U-turn here with the Landorus. We'll have to see what BO went for. He might have gone for CM again, or he might have gone for Sub again, if he knows that the Landorus Scarf. Zygarde, Megina, or Greninja are the options here, but Zygarde seems fine since it's only CM'd up once so far. So what did he go for? CM or Sub? So he went for Sub. Now TDK has to either Outrage or Thousand Arrows to break the Sub. Thousand Arrows, I guess he didn't want to give Black Oblivion a free search into Clefable if he Outraged. But I think Outrage still would have been a fine play. Like, Clefable is not that bad. Like, it doesn't really put that much pressure on him. If Clefable comes out, then he could potentially go back to Bulu or Megina. And he could then Megina Iron Head and then force the Clef to Softball, then Volt out into SD Bulu, or he could Harden to SD Bulu on the Clef. So I think maybe Outrage was the better play. But now, Black Oblivion, I don't know if he wants to stay in, because I think Bandit Thousand Arrows does around half to Megalady, and Stored Power with only one CM up probably wouldn't do much to Zygarde. So he might want to switch out into either Clef or Gliscor here. Pretty sure Gliscor will be able to take this. So you see, does 49%, Gliscor comes out. No, Black Oblivion can roost up here. If he's the speedy Gliscor, exactly, then he's faster. And now, even if he gets a high roll there with 51%, Gliscor has the poison up activated, now can eat this up easily. So TDK probably has to switch eventually into the, I think Bulu is a good play. If Black Oblivion has SD knockoff Roost and Earthquake, then Bulu walls this. So he goes Hard Greninja. I would have gone Bulu personally. Hard Greninja, and now he goes Bulu. Does he not have Ice Beam? He goes in the Heligo there, predicting an Ice Beam, or yeah, I think predicting an Ice Beam. Damn, that was risky. But yeah, this works out for Black Oblivion. I don't think he predicted the Bulu, I just think he predicted the Ice Beam. But yeah, TDK is obviously gonna switch into, potential switches are Megina, Lando, Zygarde. I don't think he's gonna go Zapdos again. Earlier he just went Zapdos predicting T-Spike on this, I think. Yeah, like, TDK is never gonna stay in here, so I would not Sludge Wave if I'm BO. I would either T-Spike or maybe double. But honestly, I don't know if Black Oblivion can win this. So he does Sludge Wave on the Lando. Landorus can U-turn here, because even if the Nihiligo stays in, it's not a big deal at all. So there's the Bulu back at it again, and Bulu kinda just gets another kill. He can either Hard Horn Leech or he can SD again. If Bio wants to break the SD, he can go Hard Nihiligo, but yeah, this is tough for him, because if Horn Leech comes out, Nihiligo would just die, I assume, because it's super friendly on the physical side. But if he stays in with the Gliscor, if he's knock off Earthquake, he can, and SD and Roost, he can't even hit this Bulu with. If he has Ice Thing or Facade, then he can hit it, yes, but Bulu will still beat it when we won. So either Horn Leech or SD is the play for TDK. I think SD is fine, because that covers the Lari coming out, and then you can hit the Lari better, but he does SD on it. Black Oblivion SD is on his own, so he must have like Ice Thing or Facade to hit the Bulu with. But the thing is, this has Horn Leech, right? So as long as it can live a hit from the Gliscor, which I'm pretty sure it can, it will just Horn Leech and kill the Gliscor and get all his health back. So to be fair, Black Oblivion didn't really have a play versus this, because like I said, if he goes hard this on a Horn Leech, he just dies. So he's just gonna Horn Leech and get all his health back, I think. Yeah, Gliscor just dies. Yeah, to be fair, like I said, he didn't have a play, because if he goes Pharaoh, then this beats the Pharaoh anyways. If he goes Clef, he loses his Clef. Lari loses to this 1v1, I think. And if he goes Hard Nihiligo, he loses the one thing that can revenge this. So he kind of had to stay in with Gliscor. Like, yeah, Facade did a good amount, but Horn Leech got all the health back. Now, TDK should switch again, obviously. Megina, Lando, Zygarde are the options. Megina's the safest, just in case this has HP Ice, you never know. Like, usually they run HP Fire, but sometimes they run HP Ice. So Megina was the safest play. BO Sludge Waves again, trying to catch him on a... Yeah, I want to say on a choke, because staying with Bula would be a misplay. Maybe not on a choke, on a misplay, that's what I should say, yeah. But yeah, he can Volt Switch here, since he got rid of the Gliscor. Volt Switch is pretty free now. And he can go back into Bula here and put pressure on Black Olivine. And this is crazy. SD Bulu was not used for a while, but it's kind of making a comeback. It was used by Zomok last week and now used by TDK. And yeah, people are going to have to start prepping for this again. Maybe we will see Tangrowth make a comeback with Sludge Bomb, AV and Fist Def Tangrowth, or Mixed Defensive Tangrowth with AV. So we simply see Hornleech here. Yep. Clef got up the rocks on SD Bulu. Now TDK can just either superpower or use his Z-move here. I assume it's, like I said earlier, all out pummeling, because like I said, with Hornleech, if you don't have Woodhammer, you don't run Grassy, you run pummeling. So there's the Z-move to kill the Pharaoh Thorn. I'm pretty sure superpower would have killed the Pharaoh as well, but he didn't need the pummeling for anything else. And that way his defense and attack doesn't get lowered, so I understand why he went for it. Now the Heli goes back in and TDK can switch back into Megina or Zygarde Lando. Most likely Megina if he's fearing HP Ice, like I said earlier. Black Oblivion could... does he even have a chance to... I don't think Black Oblivion has a chance to win this unless TDK misplays. So he doubles into Megalati. There's the Megina. So now TDK can Flurricane here. Even if Black Oblivion Calm Minds, that means yes, he can eat it up, but that forces the Lati to go for Recover, so that's fine. So there's the Flurricane. Now he can Volt Switch as Bio is gonna go for Recover. He can Volt Switch into the Zygarde, I think. That's a good play. Like I said earlier, with 1 CM up, Stored Power wouldn't do much to Zygarde. That makes sense why TDK never brought out the Zygarde on the Nihiligo, because health on Zygarde is pretty valuable if you think about the Megalati thing. So that's about the Megalati matchup. Like, if Lati only has 1 CM up, then the Zygarde can pretty much attack it for good damage. So I assume Bio is gonna sub again to scout what the Zygarde locks itself into. So we see now Outreach or Southern Arrows. Southern Arrows, yeah, I don't know. That's okay, because like I said, it does around half to the Lati. And that means Bio cannot set up for free, because he's probably gonna either sub again or CM. He does CM, okay. Because, yeah, he needs to get his special attack up. But the thing is, oh, that does 56. That has to be, like, a high roll. So he's gonna recover spam here, fishing for lower rolls. 52. But if he keeps getting these rolls that are higher than 50, then there's no way that this works out for Bio. And also, the Zygarde, even if it runs out of 1,000 arrows, the Lati is also running out of recover. So this is fine for TDK. Like, he could have Outrage to force this out, because, like I said earlier, Clef is not a big problem. He has 9 recovers left, 1,000 arrows has 6 BP left. So yeah, recover has more than 1,000 arrows, so eventually Zygarde will have to struggle if it stays in, but Lati will only have like 3 recovers left when Zygarde runs out of 1,000 arrows. There's also the chance that TDK can get a crit here. So he got a lower roll now, 47, so this is what Bio needs. He needs to have the Zygarde keep going. Lower rolls, 5 recovers left, 2,000 arrows left. So after his Zygarde runs out of 1,000 arrows, he's gonna have to switch into... okay, goes Megina. Now he's gonna Flurricane again, because he wants to force this Lati to use up a recover. And yeah, this Lati could actually, like, technically it could make a comeback. Yeah, TDK is gonna Flurry to force him to recover. Like, technically, Lati could make a comeback if it had infinite recover PP, but it's almost out of recover. So yeah, you Flurry here, force him to recover again. And then you still have U-turn with Scarf Landris. You have a Greninja that can come in on stored power. And even if Greninja can't break the sub, so he Flurricans, he gets a crit. Okay, now it's game over. I mean, to be fair, I don't think that mattered, because like I said, the Lati was low on recover PP. It only had like 2 or 3 left. But it was crazy how Lati, like, it looked like Lati could make a comeback if it wasn't for the low recover PP, right? Because, like, TDK could just keep attacking and Lati would be out of recover. U-turn from Landris, like I said, from Scarf Landris, would bring the Lati like would always damage the Ladi and would eventually not have recover PP left. Now Bio can go into his Clefable here, and the Clefable is a common rocks variant with Softball and Moonblast, right? So this is his last, he can make a last attempt to set up, but I'm pretty sure that's not gonna work. TDK can either Hard Volt out into the SD Bulu on the Clef, or he can, I mean, like, Nihiligo is not even an option, that's why I'm saying Clef. Clef is the only play here. Because if Nihiligo comes out, it can't touch Megina and it will just die to Iron Head. AV Megina carries Iron Head, Volt Switch, Flare Cannon, sometimes Ice Beam, but they not usually don't carry Ice Beam anymore. Usually it's HP Fire, yeah. But on this team, it doesn't have to be HP Fire if the Zapdos has Heat Wave. But yeah, usually it's HP Fire, especially on teams that are weak to Kartana, Scizor, stuff like that. Oh, and it also helps versus Ferrothorn. So if the Greninja doesn't have HP Fire, this might have HP Fire. So there's the Clefable. We see either Volt Switch or Iron Head. Iron Head, yep. So we can see that doesn't do much because it's max defense Clefable, and Megina doesn't run any attack investment on AV, obviously. I mean, no Megina runs attack investment. The only offensive Megina runs special attack investment. Unless you run some meme set with physical. Yeah, some people do that, like for Short on Lives meme sets with Shift Key, Z Brick Break, or some garbage to beat Chansey 1v1. But yeah, don't try this at home. Don't try the physical Megina, it's bad. Yeah, he can either keep spamming Iron Head or he can Volt out. I think Volting out is a better play because if your Clefable has too many Moonblasts up, then it will do too much damage to the Bulu. But if you Volt hard into the Bulu, then... Oh, he has Explosion? Wow. I think Explosion is for Volcarona. ABI used it once in Snake. So he can explode and then bring Volcarona in range from E-Speed from Zygarde if Explosion doesn't kill, something like that. Shout out to ABI, okay. So now Hornleech picks up the kill. And Nihiligo cannot lock into a move that hits everything, so if he Sludge Waves, he Hidden Powers, either Ice or Fire. So there's the Hornleech picks up the kill and TDK takes the win. Yeah, if he Sludge Waved, he would have been walled by Zygarde Lando. If that's Hidden Power, Ice or Fire, he's walled by Greninja, and yeah, he didn't win anyway. But yeah, I'm gonna pause it real quick and show you guys the score for this series, one second. We can see here now the Raiders were up 5-1 versus the Classied before this, so now the Raiders are up 6-1. And I think the Raiders still have a good chance to make playoffs. I'm not 100% sure how this is going. I think Classied are pretty much out. Thank you guys for watching. And yeah, this shows that SD Bulu is kind of making a comeback. And yeah, people should prep for it in the future. Like I said, we will potentially see Tangrowth make a comeback with Sludge Bomb. We will maybe see Ferrothorn run Gyro Ball again. We shall see how people try to, if we see Bulu more often, if people like prep for it. Thank you guys for watching, and smash the like button if you enjoyed. Peace out, friends.